The enemy attacks. It changes our mood. It changes our thinking. Yes, physically we become tired. We become headache, stomachache, all kinds of problems. You go to the doctor, nothing is wrong, they say. But you are still attacked. Attack of the enemy. The wages of sin is death. Physical death. Economical death. You earn, nothing remains with you. Everything goes. You earn even lakhs, it goes away. Nothing remains with you. Because the enemy has, through your sin, the enemy has entered into us. Through our sin, the enemy entered into us. And being in us, what is the most needed, the finance, he will cut off. Simply eat it up. Financial death. Emotional death. Family death. Husband and wife, simply they fight. For what reason? No reason. Once the husband and wife came like that, simply we are fighting. Only hitting is left out now. That's what they were saying. But there is no reason for what we are fighting. Both of us are having good children. Both of us have a good yearning. Both of us are having everything good. For why should we fight? We don't know, but we fight. Then when I was praying, the Lord showed me that they are addicted to pornography. And through pornography, the evil thoughts enter into their head. And without their knowledge, it makes them to fight with each other. I asked him, did you involve in watching blue films and pornography and all these things? Yes, Father. Not only that, I allowed my wife also showed her. Are why? No, I want to learn something new. What do you want to learn? That which is dirty, that which is not of God, that which is unnatural, that which is designed by the enemy to destroy the minds and families. That is the way the enemy will teach you. And they repented for their sin. They threw away all those things. They went and wiped away, rubbed off everything from their system. And then they repented for this and made a good confession. Next retreat, behold, they came. I was surprised. They came for English retreat, then they came for the Telugu retreat within 15 days. I said, what happened? Father, the day we went away from here, confessing our sin, from that day onwards, we are peaceful. We are no more fighting. We are not able to understand. Yes, the enemy sows the seed of dirt, and through which the enemy enters into sin, and through sin, he fights with us. Economical death, family death, physical death, and spiritual death, all kinds of death. But then, salvation means, though we are sinner, third, we have a Savior who carried our sin upon himself. And when the sin, he carried all the mankind's sin upon him, the sin prevented him even to see the Father. Sin has that power, as we read in Isaiah 59:1. Your sin becomes a wall between God and yourself. It becomes a wall. Yes, when that sin came upon Jesus, it hid the face of the Father. That sin hit him, destroyed him. He cried like a worm. In Psalm 22, we read, what are the things happened to Jesus when he carried the sin? That's why in John chapter 1 verse 29, John the Baptist said, here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. So the third thing, though I am a sinner, I am not left all alone. I have a Savior. So the helmet of salvation means I realize, number one, who am I in the Lord? Why did the Lord create me? Number two, the helmet of salvation means how sin has attacked me, how sin is affecting me, and I need to repent for my sin. If I don't repent for my sins, There is no salvation. We read in 2 Chronicles 7:14, if anyone who carries my name, if they repent for their sin and they give up their sin, I will come from heaven and I will bless them, and because of them I will bless their nation. Yes, not only their families, you become blessing for the nation. Yes. So God is calling us. God is calling us. So when we, because Jesus came to carry away all our sins, he shed his blood on the cross. So fourth, I take that blood and I apply it on my head. Helmet of salvation means, number four, I take the blood upon me, realizing my Lord has shed the blood for me. And what does the blood do? Number one, 1 John chapter 1 verse 7 says, the blood of Jesus cleanses me from all my sin and makes me sinless. He takes away the sin. He is the Lamb. So when I kneel before the Lord and repent for my sin, I believe in faith that the blood of Jesus is upon me. The more I recognize that, the more I recognize the truth, and I make it my own, Lord, your blood is upon me. And according to 1 John 1:7, it wipes away my sin, and I am becoming sinless. I confess it, and I make it my own. Number two, the blood of Jesus gives me the power to fight against the enemy and cast away the enemy from my life. We read in the book of Revelation chapter 12 verse 11, through the blood of the Lamb they conquered the enemy. So helmet of salvation means, I wear this truth and live out this truth. Lord, I take your blood upon me, and this blood cast away the fear from me, cast away the anger from me, cast away the depression from me, cast away the desire to go have the flesh, the desire to go and meet that man, go and meet this woman, go to phone call, feeling like phone call, I crush it in the blood of Jesus. So every sin, every obstacle, every curses that has come upon me, every evil thought comes, immediately I enter into the helmet of salvation and take the blood upon me, and I claim, Satan, get away from me. I don't want this thought from me. By the blood of Jesus, the evil spirit that brings this thought is being crushed and burnt in Jesus' blood. So I claim that. Third, the blood of Jesus begins to intercede for me. We read in 1 John chapter 2 verse 2. And we read the book of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 24. We have a mediator. 1 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16. There are so many. We have a Hebrews chapter 4 verse 15 and 16. We have a high priest who is waiting for us. We are not among those who are to be perished. So we go to the mercy gate and we receive mercy and forgiveness. Yes, we have the blood of Jesus is the intercessor. That's why Jesus says in Hebrews 10:5, you didn't like the blood of the animal, so I said, here I am, Lord, that you have given me a body, with that body's blood I come to do your will. So the blood of Jesus intercedes for us and makes us to do the will of the Father. Fourth, the blood of Jesus makes me to die to myself and to do the will of the Father.